Welcome back to another Survivor Last Song Standing playlist video. I just wrapped up one of my crowdsourced ones, for which the theme was ampersands, as in the song title or the artist title had to have an and or an ampersand in it. I've got a lot of songs, so I'm just gonna jump right in and tell you how they all ranked. When I began, I noticed that this was a very mid-range playlist. There weren't any songs on the first listen that were instant loves or instant hates, though I was sure I would grow into a few of these, and I definitely did. But since there weren't any songs I actively disliked on here, we had to jump right into the songs that are probably fine but just don't do much for me section. So that being said, number 45 was The Boy with the Arab Strap by Belle and Sebastian. There is a specific style of indie pop rock that Belle and Sebastian are very reminiscent of, whose lyrics are so inscrutable that I sometimes wonder if they mean anything at all. They feel more like a series of random images, like you'd see in a dream, and the sound of the song doesn't do much to enlighten me. This one, according to the band members, is maybe about a member of the band Arab Strap, but it just does nothing for me. Either musically or lyrically. I know people love Belle and Sebastian, but I've just never been able to fall in love with them, and unfortunately this time that's enough to kick them off early. Number 44 was Glitter and Gold by Barnes Courtney. I've had one other Barnes Courtney song suggested in my playlists, and I enjoyed it pretty well, but for some reason this one doesn't work for me nearly as well. Like all the songs in here, it's not bad, but his vocals sound so uncomfortable on the low notes, and the lyrics don't really stand out to me in any way, and the sound is okay, but I'm kind of tired at this faux epic Imagine Dragons Fallout Boy kind of rock anthem. I just don't anticipate it gaining traction from here on out. Number 43 is D&D plus Asexuality by Skull Puppies. I kept wanting to like this song more than I did. It's got nerdy themes, and it talks about asexuality, which hardly ever gets songs. I should approve of it. It's almost certainly someone's Yes, Finally Someone Gets Me song, and I love those. I guess that's the thing. I approve of it, and I'm glad it exists, but I don't enjoy listening to it on a musical level. I don't like the singer's voice, I find the tune very repetitive, and I just don't see it growing on me anytime soon. Worth checking out, but I'm done listening to it. Number 42 is Alligator by Of Monsters and Men. We're at the stage of the playlist where songs that have made zero impression on me thus far are getting kicked off, and that's this one. It's the brand of indie pop rock that I have difficulty connecting to as anything more than background music. I really like the driving rhythm of it, but I have no memory of it once it's over, and I don't think that's likely to change. Number 41 is Pancho and Lefty by Townes Van Zandt. I like the Spanish language pieces of the songs more than the English, and that kept it around for a few plays, but it's still just not resonating with me. The narrative isn't drawing me in, the vocals aren't wowing me, the melody is repetitive in a way that I get tired of instead of appreciating more as it repeats. It's fine, it just isn't growing on me, so it's probably time to cut it loose and let it go be free and maybe wow someone else, or however that works. Number 40 is Teach Your Children by Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young. This is a pleasant little song, but I can't shake the sense of folksy cheeriness it brings along with it. I can't pinpoint exactly what about this song makes me roll my eyes at it a little bit, but that hasn't changed in the last several listens, so I think at this point I have to accept that this song just isn't going to work for me and let it go. It's got some nice vocals to it though, so that was pleasant to listen to. Number 39 is Kiss and Control by AFI. After 7 listens, it's becoming clear which songs are just not going to get any more memorable, and this is one of them. I've liked AFI before, and I'm not opposed to the song really, but it doesn't do much for me. And it's the only one that when it starts playing, I think, have I heard this one before? Turns out I have, 7 times. It just doesn't make an impression on me. Number 38 is 46 and 2 by Brass Against, so this is definitely intriguing. Brass Against does brass-heavy covers of like angry rock songs. This one is originally by Tool. On its face, this should be something I really dig, but this particular song just doesn't do a lot for me. I can't quite find my way into the lyrics, which makes the angry tone a little unsatisfying, and I don't love the vocals on the chorus, they sound too small for the rest of it. Definitely a musical project I want to check out more of, but I don't love this song by itself. Number 37 is Blood, Muscle, Skin, and Bone by Brandi Carlile. This one initially placed quite a bit higher, I think. I like the sweet meaning of the lyrics, and it's a nice little peppy tune, and the vocal slide up into the chorus is a lot of fun, but after 9 listens, it's becoming clear that it doesn't quite stand up to the rest of the songs on this playlist. It immediately leaves my mind after I hear it, and it doesn't seem to be gaining any traction. Number 36 is Lost, Scared, and Tired by Jared and the Mill. While I wish it could give bonus points for having an ampersand in both the artist and the song name, it probably wouldn't make the song more interesting to me. I was halfway through this last listen when I realized I had no idea what the song was. It faded away from me while I was listening to it. It's fine, it's very pleasant background or driving music, and I really like the banjo that kicks in about a minute and a half, but it's not grabbing me further than that. Number 35 is Live and Learn from Sonic Adventure 2. There are certainly a handful of Sonic songs I do have a nostalgic attachment to, but this isn't one of them. I do like its high energy. This would be a great workout song for me, I think, but it's not really all that interesting to listen to on its own outside of context. Maybe if it had less generic lyrics, the music would pop for me more. Number 34 is Patience by Guns N' Roses. I'm a fairly new discoverer of Guns N' Roses, and when I like them a lot, but I pretty consistently prefer their upbeat songs to their ballads, which always feel a little draggy to me. I have the same reaction to this one. It's pretty and it's soothing, but I'm just not interested enough to listen to it for 6 minutes. But I'm glad I got to know it a little bit better. Number 33 is Taking on Water by Maylene and the Sons of Disaster. The chorus of the song is definitely the most interesting part, and I like that quite a bit. It has a weirdly satisfying melody and vocal performance, but as a whole, the song is still missing something. The verses feel pretty consistently lackluster, and the lyrics are pretty generic, and the chorus can't quite make up for that. Number 32 is Mary Jane's Last Dance by Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. I've hardly ever listened to Tom Petty, but he's got a real Bob Dylan thing going on with his vocals, huh? I really enjoy the aimless atmosphere of these lyrics, and the harmonies on the chorus are nice, and I like that harmonica in between the chorus and the verse, so I like a lot of individual pieces of the song, but it doesn't quite come together enough to keep it in the playlist beyond this point. Number 31 is The Phantom of the Opera by Me First and the Gimme Gimmes. A completely different song was set to go off this round, but then this one played, and I realized it was its time. So I love some Phantom of the Opera, and I love the concept of Me First and the Gimme Gimmes, but I seldom want to actually listen to their Broadway covers. I always miss the overt musicality of the show tunes versions, and the lyrics to this one just don't justify this kind of angry, almost tuneless yelling. Like, it's supposed to be this seductive, luring song, and there's just obviously none of that in the sound of it. It's a really fun idea, but like most Me First of the Gimme Gimme songs, it wore out its welcome pretty quickly and is gonna go now. Number 30 is Awake and Alive by Skillet. Skillet always has a bit of a nostalgic vibe for me, but the more I actually listen to them as an adult, the more I am just aware that all their songs sound exactly the same. It's not a bad sound, it's just unvaried, which means anytime one shows up in my Last Song Standing playlist, I feel like I'm repeating all the Skillet songs I've ever heard every time I play it, and so it runs out of steam fast. This is fine, it's just not standing out for me. Number 29 is Coming Home by City & Color. This is another one that scored fairly highly on my first listen and then slowly fell with each play. It apparently just doesn't lend itself to repetition well. I like the melancholy tune and the vocal performance, but after several listens, it started to come across less as melancholy and more as just dreary. And I find myself preferring the more energetic songs remaining on my playlist over this one. Number 28 is Illusion and Dream by Poets of the Fall. I really love the sad melody of this song. It's so atmospheric and mournful, and that works really well for me. What doesn't work as well are the lyrics, which have very teenage, I just figured out that sometimes the government or media or grown-ups in general lie to us so nothing matters language. And while the overall message of it isn't terrible, the specific lyrics just sound so young and so earnest that I can't quite take them seriously. It's a good listen, but it doesn't stack up to the rest. Number 27 is Glamorous Indie Rock and Roll by The Killers. Sometimes I really love The Killers, and sometimes they're just okay. This is mostly just okay, but somewhere in between. I really love the vocal performance on this, particularly with the slight echo, and the guitars on the chords are very fulfilling. I'm not exactly sure how to put that into words, but the lyrics don't do much for me, and I don't love the music alone quite enough to let it keep going past this point. Number 26 is Broken Crown by Mumford & Sons. I ended up with two Mumford & Sons songs in this playlist, which wasn't super exciting because I just don't care about them at all. This one is fine. It has a nice rocky energy to it that I appreciate. It definitely keeps the song interesting past the halfway mark. But these lyrics are difficult to parse, in a way I find irritating rather than intriguing, and the first part of the song lags before it kicks into high gear, so it's probably time for it to go. Number 25 is Dust Bowl Dance Live by Mumford & Sons. I didn't actually expect to eliminate both Mumford & Sons songs back to back, but when I got to this one this time around, I was just ready to get rid of it. I initially thought it'd last a little bit longer because I do follow the lyrics on this one, and I find them to be telling an interesting narrative, and I like the musical break toward the end quite a bit and how it builds to a greater intensity. But while I like a lot of the individual pieces, I'm also just kind of tired of listening to it, so it's just time to go. Number 24 is Up and Down by Girly. I kept thinking this was going to last a lot longer, but then I realized I was confusing a song having energy with me liking it, and this song isn't actually that interesting to me. And there's not a good reason. It has all the hallmarks of a song I like, down to the British-accented speak singing on the verses. Why do I love that? I don't know. I've now listened to it 3 times, trying to figure out why it doesn't work, and the best answer I have is that the lyrics are more generic than the sound, so it's not a nice match, but I don't have a good answer. It's just time for it to go. Number 23 is The Killing Moon by Echo and the Bunnymen. This one has had one of the most unexpectedly long lives. I kept thinking it'll leave this time, and then it just didn't. I kept enjoying the dark ambiance of the song more than whatever I ended up kicking off. However, we are rapidly moving out of the nothing wrong with them, they just don't wow me section into the okay, these are starting to wow me section. And this one is the last holdout, so I think it's finally reached its point. I should check out more by this band, though. Number 22 is Time After Time by She and Him. The crooner ballad version of She and Him is definitely preferable to the cutesy indie ukulele version of She and Him. It's a fun, sweet tune that was enjoyable to listen to, but as crooner ballads go, the lyrics and tune really aren't that interesting, so even though I added some really nice variety to my playlist, it's time for it to go. Number 21 is Believe by Brooks and Dunn. This is the first of two Brooks and Dunn songs suggested here. Both have a story-centric and melodic theatricality to them that are appealing to me. I love the big soaring melody on this chorus, and of course, as a religious person myself, I have some connection to this theme of growing and discovering faith. However, this is also so sentimental and cheesy in the actual lyrics that it reminds me of what I dislike most about CCM. I was able to tune out the lyrics enough to really enjoy the vocals and music for the last several rounds, but I think I've reached the end of that trick working, so it's time for it to go. Number 20 is Me and My Broken Heart by Rixton. This is certainly a catchy little tune. I always enjoy listening to it and dancing along to it, but it's the last of the mostly unmemorable tunes. Definitely the most fun of those tunes in the moment, which is why it made it well past the top half and into the top 20, but it's not as distinct as the rest of the songs on the list. Number 19 is Me and Becky by Chris Rice. So, this is complicated, and it's going to get personal and kind of sad. Because on one hand, I like this song. It's cheerful and fun, and I like the meaning of it a lot, but it doesn't wow me. It might have lasted a little bit longer, but then a thing happened. This month, the church came out and said that they are investigating credible allegations of Rice sexually assaulting a male student in the youth group while he worked at their church. And while obviously I don't know the full story or the answers, this shook me. Rice's music has meant so much to me over the years and has been such an important piece of my faith journey, and learning he might have also done some really crappy things was a real punch to the gut. So I'm still processing all that, but in the meantime, listening to a song of his that I only like, don't love, on repeat isn't really giving me the space I need to process, so I'm going to remove it for now. Number 18 is Cities and Dust by Susie and the Banshees. I don't know Susie and the Banshees at all, but I kind of fell in love with the sound of the song. It's got such a cool, dark vibe to it, and I love the wailing vocals, and I love those weird, eerie bells in the chorus. It's just a lot of fun, and I'm glad I got to know it, even if it's not quite as captivating as the other songs remaining on the list. Number 17 is Saved and Free by Denver and the Mile High Orchestra. So this one has seriously fluctuated in my playlist, because while I absolutely adore the huge, dramatic, theatrical gospel sound to the music, especially in the last chorus, and I find the lyrics in the chorus to be a good encouragement, the verses do not work for me. Verse 1 is incredibly condescending, and both verses imply that if you are a Christian, you'll never be sad again, which, well, is simply not the case. And the condescension in the first verse makes me strongly suspect this songwriter would be one of those folks who would blame my depression on some lack of faith on my part, which is not a good look. So sometimes I forgot about how much I hated the verses and would super enjoy the choruses and the bridge and be like, this is top 10! And then sometimes I'd actually hear them and be like, oh no, this is going off next, just for another one to slip out at the last second instead. So it's been all over the place, but I like the rest of these songs enough that the flaws of the song finally outweigh the good, so it's heading on out. Number 16 is For Me and My Gal by Judy Garland and Gene Kelly. This is a sweet little song with good performers, and there's not any reason for it to land higher on the list except that it always remains firmly in the pleasant like but not love camp. The lyrics don't really stand out to me, and the melody is very basic, and the performances rise to the level of the song but not above it. It was lovely to have in my playlist as the most show-tuney of the remaining tunes, but I think it's not going to gain any more traction. Number 15 is Betty and Me by Jonathan Colton. This is probably the song I was most familiar on my playlist, given how obsessively I used to follow all things JoCo. This one always makes me smile a little, despite being a fairly depressing narrative about a man whose wife is 100% cheating on him, but he doesn't know it yet. But it's such a cheerful little tune, and it's so much fun to sing along with. It isn't my favorite JoCo tune, though, and it doesn't really hit me on any kind of emotional level, so it is definitely the least great of the songs left on this list. Off it goes. Number 14 is Love Hurts by Joan Jett and the Blackhearts. This just feels like a good old-fashioned sad rock ballad. It's not unique or super out of the box, but it's got a simplicity to its mournfulness. It doesn't need to use elaborate metaphors. It's just straightforward and very honest and authentic in its declaration of how love hurts. This would work so well as a cathartic breakup or unrequited love song. I really enjoy it. Number 13 is High and Dry by Radiohead. so I have never gotten into Radiohead and was not looking forward to listening to this. The only one of theirs I really like is A Wolf at the Door, but it turns out this one's pretty darn good too. While A Wolf at the Door hits me hard because of the lyrics, this one just has a really soothing and pretty melody and instrumentation that puts me in such a nice chill mood, which I appreciate. The lyrics are vague and who knows what they're about, but it's still a nice song to listen to. It was a really great surprise. Number 12 is Homeward Bound by Simon and Garfunkel. Ending up with two songs by the same artist can sometimes work in the song's favors and sometimes against them. In this case, it worked mostly in its favor, as the two Simon and Garfunkel songs on the list melded in my mind as, yeah, I like those both equally. And it wasn't until now, at number 12, that I realized I actually like this one quite a bit less than the other. I still really enjoy it, but the energy of the verses to the chorus is a little whiplashy, just enough to get it kicked off now. But the melody and harmonies and instrumentation are all still great, and I'm glad I got to listen to it more. Number 11 is Hands Up and Amen by Billy Ray Martin. It was a wrestling match between this and one other song to get into the top 10, and this one just barely lost. I have no idea what the song is about, but it's got such an interesting and creative sound to it, especially with the singer's voice, and I just found myself loving it every time it played. That novelty is worn just thin enough now that it's going to leave, but I really enjoyed getting to know this song. Number 10 is Me and My Dog by Boy Genius, aka Julian Baker, Phoebe Bridgers, and Lucy Dacus. I really need to check out more of these individual artists one of these days. There's something that's just haunting about this tune. So many little individual lyrics that stand out and punch into my gut even while I couldn't offer a one-to-one translation of what they mean, and really simple and lovely melodies and instrumentation and vocal performances on top of it all combined to make something really beautiful. It's getting exceptionally difficult to kick out songs now, of course, but here we go. Number 9 is Monsters and Angels by Voice of the Beehive. I've never heard of this band before, but I really enjoyed this, as evidenced by the song making it into my top 10. I love the doubled vocals and the dramatic instrumentation on the chorus. It just gives it all such a soaring feel that made me smile every time the song came on. I'm definitely gonna have to check out more of their stuff because this was a good listen. Number 9 is Money Grabber by Fits and the Tantrums. At one point, I thought this might win the entire thing, and while it hasn't quite made it there, it's still done very well. I love the retro sound of the music and the powerhouse anthemic vocals on the chorus and those horns. It's just a ton of fun, and I guess I really need to check out this band more since this and Hand Clap have both scored super high in these playlists. Number 7 is Scarborough Fair by Simon and Garfunkel. I was pretty familiar with the song already, but it was so nice to get to listen to it again more in depth. It's just absolutely gorgeous. The lyrics and that harpsichord in the background just gives it such a gorgeous, old-timey, eerie, magic feel. It's getting tougher and tougher to kick off songs, but I think right now this is the right choice. Number 6 is Fire and Rain by James Taylor. I was actually only tangentially aware of this song. I definitely didn't know it well, but I really love the melancholy feel of it, and there's something very sad about the simplicity of the line, "I always thought that I'd see you again." It's pretty and mournful, and Taylor's vocals are of course great to listen to. I'm glad I got to know this song for real. Number 5 is You Make My Dreams Come True by Daryl Hall and John Oates. Another one I kinda sorta knew, but was delighted to get the chance to know better. It's such a mood lifter of a song. It's got this bouncy instrumentation and those jaunty ooh-oohs, and the vocals are just so cheerful and upbeat. It just always made me smile whenever it came on the playlist. Number 4 is Gin and Juice by Snoop Dogg. I should really check out more Snoop Dogg. He always manages to be laid back without being lethargic. This tune has such a cool, chill vibe to it. I'm not sure I have much else to say about it, but I just love the vibe it puts out and the groove to it every time it played, and I had a great time getting to know it. Number 3 is You and I by Lady Gaga. This has been my favorite Lady Gaga song for some time. I just love the sort of bluesy ballad nature of it. I think Gaga's vocals are top-notch here, and I love the simplicity and evocative nature of the lyrics. It's just a really great tune. And the only reason it's going off now and not making it to the top two is because since it is a long-term favorite of mine, it has been a tad overplayed, and I'd rather give the win to a newer discovery. But it's always a joy to listen to this one. Coming in at number 2 is Neon Moon by Brooks and Dunn. So my friend who gave me this song has been consistently submitting country songs that I consistently rank low, so it's a delightful surprise to both of us, I'm sure, to see this one make it into the top 2. I love this song so much. It's got all these great jazz torch song vibes, and the mournful wailing vocals of country really work here. And I can see the bar and the jukebox and the neon lights as he describes them. This perfectly captures the atmosphere of the song, and I'm so glad I got to fall in love with this tune. And number 1 is Don't Think Twice, It's Alright by Peter, Paul, and Mary. I really didn't know this song very well, and I definitely hadn't actually listened to the lyrics. Ooh, they have some snark to them, which is a fun contrast to this incredibly pretty tune. And as always with Peter, Paul, and Mary, these harmonies are just so great. This was a song that I almost always stopped what I was doing to pay attention to, which is an accomplishment by the time it gets to the end of these playlists. So that was my crowdsourced playlist that I listened to in September and October. As that one wound down, I solicited suggestions for my next one, and you'll just have to subscribe to find out what that theme was and what songs people submitted. In the meantime, feel free to tell me what song would you have suggested with an ampersand to either the song title or the artist, and were there any of these that were ranked unfairly low? Probably a lot of them.